If your travels this weekend take you by Cockeysville Middle School, you might want to swing by with a bag filled with non-perishables. The school is taking part in a Stuff a Bus campaign aimed at helping the Maryland Food Bank, and they need it. 11 News reporter Jennifer Franciotti has more.
At Cockeysville Middle School, students are hard at work on a lesson hard to understand. They're filling a bus with food for the hungry, donations for the Maryland Food Bank.
It's really fun because you like help people and feels good.
I think it's really good because we get to like help all the people in need.
I think that it's very neat that we're going to help the hungry and homeless.
Last year we raised 6,800 pounds and on the Stuff the Bus of last year we raised 2,200 pounds. So we're really excited to equal those numbers or beat them this year.
The Maryland Food Bank is giving out more food than ever before, and now with just 3 weeks to go before Thanksgiving, they say their shelves are dangerously empty.
We're getting more food in, and it's going out just as quickly, so it's just really scary for us right now.
Shauna Yetman with the Maryland Food Bank says the agency tries to help 370,000 residents a year, but with the economy, the need is up 20% to 25%, and it's affected the middle class now more than ever. Drives like this, she says, are important, and more are coming this month.
There are tons of ways to give to the Maryland Food Bank this month. We're really excited about it. We're going to be partnering with City Financial this weekend, November 8th and 9th.
Every November, on a one weekend, we have had employees working with Giant as our partner to have people bring food to those Giants, and we collect it and then work with them to unload it.
We're going to be doing Stuff a Bus on November 22nd, the Ravens Food Drive on November 23rd, and if you can't go to any of those, you can go to our website and buy holiday cards from us, and you can also go to our virtual food drive.
Just reaching deep and helping others.
Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.